the untold story of an engineer. Almost 15 lakhs of engineers graduate every year in our country. About 35 to 40% of the engineering students drop out in the first year or they change their majors. About 30% of the students don't even clear their first year of engineering. About 40 to 45% of the people take up engineering only because of their parental pressure. About 6% of the engineering students are just fit to be employed. All these things I am not saying. It's all through the Google statistics. Please understand, guys. All these things are through the Google statistics. So you can just understand that just 6% of the engineers are fit to be employed. In this present generation, it's not difficult to find an engineer, is it? So you ask anybody, what are you doing? The first answer you get is nothing but engineering. Okay, so let's take an example. So let's take an example of 10 students. So I'm pretty sure that 5 students have taken up engineering because they are having a passion towards that field. They really love that field. But what about the remaining 5 students? What about the remaining 5 students? Those 5 students have taken up engineering just because of their parental pressure, or maybe say because of some any other random reason. And few of them must be inspired by a few movies such as, say, Quirik Party or Jolly Days or maybe Three Idiots. So they must be inspired by those movies and they have just thought that, you know, let me take up engineering, let me take up this course. But is it a smart idea or is it a smart thing to take up engineering when you know that you are not having a potential for it? Yeah, so let's take one more example. So let's take an example of 7 out of 10 students who have graduated. Are you guys sure that all of them will get a job? Are you sure that, you know, say that I've taken a random of, say, 7 students out of 10 who have completed engineering. Do you think all the 7 people will get a job? No. Only 2 or 3 will land up having a best job, or the job what they have thought for, or the job which they wanted to get. Only, say, hardly 3 out of 7 will get a job. Now, what about the remaining 5 people? So I'm sure in that 5 people, say, 1 person will plan for an M.Tech. Yeah, he plans for an M.Tech thinking that it's a chance, you know, he might get a better job. It's an opportunity where he can convert it into a better job. The second person might plan up for something called as MBA. Tired of engineering, but still he's planning for MBA so that maybe he might have some better opportunity in life. The remaining person, that's the third person, might try his luck in the film industry. The fourth person might apply for the government job. But what about that last person? What about the fifth person? I'm pretty sure that fifth person will surely land up as a driver in Uber or Ola, or maybe as a delivery guy. But who is responsible for all this? Who is responsible for this? Can you tell me, guys? Can we blame anybody? Can we blame anybody for this situation? Can we blame the parents who force their kids to take up engineering? Can we blame the students who have taken up engineering? Can we blame the government who was not capable of providing us enough employment? I guess I don't have the answer for this. And I'm pretty sure none of us will have an answer for this. Engineers have become a piece of comedy these days. They spent 4 years of studying almost 45 to 47 subjects with 14 labs, so many tests, surprise tests, assignments, adding with mini projects, and finally one main project. And finally that main project, and I'm pretty sure all the engineers who are seeing this video and all the people who are seeing this video, I know the pain when you come to the final year and when you're submitting that project. I know how difficult it is, how your guide play up with you, and how much you have to struggle. I know that pain. And clearing the backlogs is not a joke. But still, people find ways to comment funny things about an engineer. After all the humiliation, finally, engineers end up taking a job which is not related to even their field, which is out of the box, which is just paying themselves 15 to 20,000 per month. In spite of all the struggle, engineers are treated like comedians these days. But have you guys ever imagined a life without an engineer? Right from the zip in your pant to the safety pin, the chair that you're sitting on, your house, the roads in front of your house, the car on the road, the electric pole, the electricity in the pole, the TV at your house, the thing what have been used for recording, the smartphone that we are currently using, all these are possible because of an engineer. You get excited whenever you see a new app or a software get released, or a new vehicle which gets released in the market. But did you realize the role of an engineer behind all this? Whenever you want to build a house, the first person who comes in your mind is nothing but an engineer. Whenever you're planning to build a house, the first person who you think about is an engineer. But at the same time, when you come across the potholes, damaged roads, you are quick enough to make comments on an engineer, and you make him responsible for all those things. And at the end of the day, all the complaints and remarks, you still choose to watch a comedy by an engineer on YouTube. You also fail to identify the engineers who are great directors, photographers, actors, musicians, and scriptwriters. I do agree, there are so many people who have taken up engineering against their will, but do not forget all those passionate engineers behind the technology that you are enjoying, the smartphones, the bike, and so on, and so many things to add on to this list. Please never forget those passionate engineers who are really working hard to do something nice for the society. Doctors are savior of life. Bankers are the saviors of economy. Teachers are the backbone of education. But remember, guys, without an engineer, all these people cannot do their work with any ease. They cannot do their work easily. It doesn't matter if you are an engineer by choice or not, but if you are an engineer, then be proud to be an engineer. So this is Sushi, mechanical engineer, and I'm proud to be a mechanical engineer. So guys, I hope you all have enjoyed this video. I hope you have understood the pain of an engineer. It's very emotional thing for me, this video, because it's taken me back to my engineering days, where we all struggled, had a lot of fun, had many things, I had a lot of memories. So hope you all have enjoyed this video. Please take care, stay safe, and yes, my dear kids, my dear students, and my dear friends, be smart enough to select the field what you really want to take up. So be that passionate engineer. Don't take up engineering simply because of your parental pressure, or maybe you just see some movie and say, okay, let me do this, let me take up this. Never do that. Yeah. So all the best to everyone. Please take care, stay safe, have a great time.